Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about how LED display works, that means function of LED display. Along with that, we are also going to find out the various advantage, disadvantage and applications of LED display in the discussion. So let's begin with the topic. LED stands for light emitting diode display. LED display are the technology which is not considered as a new technology. It was invented in 1967. Now in this video, we are going to talk about the various functioning of LED display. So let's start with the discussion. So basically, LED screen is considered as an LCD screen only, but rather than using a CCFL backlight, it uses a light emitting diode as a source of light behind the screen. So an LED screen is actually LCD screen, but instead of having normal CCFL, it uses source of light as a LED. An LED is more energy efficient and a lot smaller than CCFL, and therefore thinner television screen is possible. If we look at the size of LED and if we look at the size of CCFL, so definitely the size of LED is smaller as compared to size of CCFL. And because of that, it is possible to provide more flat or more thin display, or we can say more thin television display as compared to LCD display. There have been prototypes of real LED TVs. They didn't have the LCD panel, but instead three small colored LED per pixel. That means the per pixel we are going to use three primary colored LED, that is R, G and B. This would have been a lot better, but unfortunately the manufacturing cost was too high as compared to LCD. Because for every and each pixel, we are going to use three different color LED, that means three different primary color LED, and that is for every pixel. Therefore, the manufacturing cost is get increased as compared to LCD. OLED TV are very much similar to this and will hopefully become affordable within few days. Nowadays, if you look at the price of the OLED, then it will become very much higher as compared to other normal display because of the main drawback of the manufacturing cost. But in coming years, it may possible that the manufacturing cost get reduced and therefore the price of OLED will also get reduced. So now moving back towards the LED, there are three main configurations of LED as a backlight for the television screen, and the configurations are full array, edge lit and direct lit. Now let's move on to what do you mean by these three. Now first we are going to talk about the full array LED. So this method is considered the best LED backlighting type, but it can found only in the limited numbers of model. In full array LED screen, the LED are distributed evenly behind the entire screen. So rather than having an unequal division of the LEDs are distributed equally around the screen and that are present behind the screen. This produces a more uniform backlight and provide more effective use of local dimming, where it can change the luminance of the only specific part of the screen. So rather than changing the luminance of the entire screen, it is possible to change the luminance of only specific part of screen by using this type of LED array, that is called as full LED array. In some television like Sony XBR line, they use a colored LED instead of the white ones. Technically, this can create even greater color range by matching the backlight color with the picture. In practice though, you will not take the difference, but now in case certain application or in certain TV model, instead of using a white LEDs, they uses the color LED, and because of that it is possible to produce the more accurate picture detail as compared to the LEDs which uses a white color LED. But this is not commonly easily distinguishable by the human eyes. So this is the diagram of full array LED backlight, where we can see this the front television screen is nothing but the television screen, and behind that a full array of LED is present, in which the LEDs are equally distributed at the uniform distance, and these LEDs are used for producing a backlight rather than blocking the light. The second method is nothing but edge lit. Now in this is the most common method in all the LED television set. An edge LED screen The LEDs are placed at the peripheral of the screen. As its name indicates, the LEDs are present or the LEDs are placed at the peripheral, that means at the edge of the screen. Depending on the television, it can be found around screen or only on the sides or only at the bottom. This allows screen to be very thin. Rather than having the uniform distribution of the LEDs throughout the screen, the LEDs can be placed only at the bottom or it may be placed only at the side. And because of this, it is possible to reduce the size of display. That means making the display more thinner as compared to other television set. However, it can cause some spots on the screen to be brighter than other, like edges. As the LEDs are placed only at the bottom or only at the sides of the LED or in only at the sides of the display, therefore it may be possible that some part of the screen may look more brighter as compared to other part. This problem is called as flash lighting or clouding, and it can be seen when watching dark scene in the dark environment. So this problem is get more dominant in case of dark screen or when we watch a dark scene in case of dark environment. So this is what about the edge lit backlight. As the name indicates, the LEDs are present only at the sides corner, or we can say the LEDs are placed only at the bottom side or only at the upper side, because of which spots get created or some part of the screen becomes more brighter as compared to other part, and that is called as flashlight. And this will get more dominant when we watch a dark scene in dark environment. So this is what about the edge lit backlight. This is the TV screen, which is present on the front, and at the back side the LED backlight is present on the edges of the screen. Next is nothing but the direct lit. Now, in direct lit, the lower end LEDs are constructed. We can say the lower end LEDs, like similarly to the full method array, the LEDs are directly behind the screen. Rather than having a filter or rather than having a lens, the LEDs are present, as the name indicates, it is direct lit. Therefore, the LEDs are present directly at the behind or back side of the screen. They are very few of them and they cannot control separately too much the luminance of the picture. These TVs are not thin because of the space required behind the screen to add LEDs and to diffuse light over the big areas. So the size of this display is somehow more, not much more thinner as compared to the other types of LEDs. So this is how the direct LED or direct lit LED backlights look like. The front part is nothing but the screen of the LED, and at the back side directly the LEDs are placed, and because of that the space requirement is more, and we can say the size of this type of LED is more as compared to other types of LED. So this is about the functions of LED, in which the LEDs are used for producing the backlight, or we can use it as a source of light for producing the backlight in case of LED display. So I hope you understand this topic of functions of LED display. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.